In this presentation, we're going to make a custom pledge form from an invoice. In other words, we're going to take our standard invoice and convert it to a pledge form, the form that we will be used when someone makes a pledge to contribute in the future. Let's get into it with Intuit QuickBooks Online. Here we are in our not-for-profit company dashboard. Going to go on over to our Excel worksheet just to consider our objective. So we're in the third tab. The third tab here, we're looking at the transaction to be. Now notice last time we had a transaction where we had a contributions of cash and we debited cash and increased the contributions without donor restrictions. This time we're going to say that there's a pledge. They promised to give us money. Now the pledge is a little bit different. If you look at this as a comparison to a for-profit type of organization, if you get the money at this point in time, then there's no transaction took place because we haven't given anything. It's just a donation, right? So, and if you're talking about a for-profit type of organization, we would have done goods or services, had to change hands, and we would have gotten cash. But it's similar to that type of transaction because we got the cash at that point in time and could be guaranteed of in essence the cash. When we talk about a pledge, then similar kind of process, but someone has promised to give us cash in the future. Again, we can't really depend on that fully because we haven't given anything. We haven't given goods or services, and therefore they don't really owe us the pledge other than just basically a promise has been made at that point in time. So a promise has been made for a pledge in the future, which is similar to an invoice, right? So this first one we created a sales receipt for. Now we want to think about an invoice and convert the invoice in essence to a pledge type of document, in which case we can track the people who have pledged us money. We could track the donors who pledged us money in a similar fashion as we would track customers who we've done goods or services for, given goods or done services for, and then owe us money in the future. The other side is going to go to contributions, and we're going to put with donor restrictions here to recognize the fact that we don't yet have the cash. We haven't done anything really to earn the cash, so there's kind of a time restriction that we're going to recognize that it's restricted at that point. So I'm going to minimize this and say, all right, first let's think about how we could adjust our invoice so that we can make it basically a pledge document. And I'm just going to try to change the name in a similar way as we did with the sales receipt. So on the customer side, you'll recall last time we changed the sales receipt so that when we print it out, it basically says donor on it, receipt. And so here we want to do a similar thing for the invoice. We'd like to make the invoice. We're not giving goods or services. It's not really an invoice. It's going to be a pledge kind of item. So we'd like to kind of change that to a pledge document. So to do that, let's go up top and go to the little cog up top as we did before. We're going to go to the accounting and settings, or account and settings under the your company. Then we want to go to the sales on the left-hand side. So we're going to go to the sales on the left-hand side. And then we want to customize look and feel. So we want to customize the look and feel, the big green button up top. Now we're going to be making a new style. We want to make a new style for this time, the invoice. So new style on the right, this time for an invoice. And this is where you have a lot of design changes that you can make, change up the template, make the logo, try other colors, and so on and so forth. You want to make it look, you know, like a nice pledge type of document. And then we want to go to the content section. And in essence, we're just going to change this invoice up here to pledge. And again, you could do other kind of customization as you would like as well. But we're going to go down to the form item down here. And we want to say, I'm going to put here and call it a pledge. So this is a pledge. When we print this form, it'll now say pledge as opposed to invoice up top. So when we go into the invoice, it'll still say invoice, but then when we print it, it'll at least say pledge here as we give this to the pledger. So then we're going to say done. And now again, so here we have our template here. So what I'm going to do is now I'm going to hit the little drop down to the right of it. I'm going to hit the drop down. I think I went into the editing. I'm going to see if I can go back. I don't want to edit it. I want to select that little drop down, and then I want to make that the default. So I'm going to make that the default. So whenever we make an invoice, it should default then to our template that we made here. So now it's still going to say invoice when we go into it. So if I go to the new item or plus, it's still going to say invoice here. I'm not going to actually make one, but let's just look at the document and we will make an invoice, which will be a pledge form later. But when you go and print it down here, if I forget to do the printing option, then you could take a look at it when we actually do make the invoice. If you print it here, then it should say pledge up top. So when you go into it, it's still going to say invoice. It's still going to use the terminology. And obviously, an invoice and a pledge are comparable kind of things for a for-profit and a not-for-profit. The difference between the terminology is a result, of course, of an invoice, meaning there has been some kind of transaction that took place resulting in the invoice, typically, meaning work has been done, services have been done, or that we have provided goods. With a pledge, all there is a promise. There has been no actual work that's been done. We haven't done anything for the money. Right? They just said, yeah, we'll give you money in the future, which is, of course, kind of the difference between the for-profit and the not-for-profit. From a functional standpoint, what's going to happen? Accounts receivable is going to go up, and we're going to record some kind of income. That's what the invoice does, that's what this invoice or this document will drive itself to do, as we'll see in a following presentation. So I'm going to close that back out, going to go back to the dashboard, and that's going to be it for now. Let's get out of here.